Honorable Sri Anil Desai Ji.
Thank you from Lok Sabha. Thank you, Deputy Chairman, sir. The people of India had great hopes on Honorable Finance Minister Sri Nirmala Sitaraman Ji when she presented the Union Budget for the year 21-22. Sir, to put India back on a recovery path following a deep recession induced by COVID-19 and the consequent lockdowns, the budget this year had to be one like never before, as was promised by Honorable Finance Minister. But the budget has belied the expectations of people of India. The budget was presented in a new format with six pillars to create Atmanirbhar Bharat. Huge outlay of expenditure has been made under these six pillars. Sir, my state of Maharashtra was the worst hit state, and Mumbai had the highest number of COVID afflicted cases as the pandemic had attacked India. But the way and the deft hands Honorable Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray Ji had handled the situation and controlled the pandemic from spreading further, it has been acclaimed by WHO, and Washington Post also took note of it. And later on, the surveys which were conducted all over the country, my chief minister happened to figure in first five chief ministers of the country. Sir, now 35,000 crores have been provided in this budget for COVID-19 vaccines. It is expected by the states that they will be provided COVID-19 vaccines free of cost by the central government, as most of the states are cash-strapped due to the onslaught of pandemic. I hope Finance Minister assures the House on this count in a reply. Sir, under the head financial capital, all-out support for the development of world-class fintech hub at GIFT IFFC has been declared under the budget. Sir, initially Mumbai was declared and is still an international financial services center, as Mumbai is financial center of financial capital of the country and also globally known as India's financial center. With great regret, I would mention here that it looks like with an objective to sideline Mumbai and deprive its pride of place, the government seems to have accelerated the pace of developing IFFC at Ahmedabad, which is reflected in this budget. Further, sir, the push to create new infrastructure is appreciable, but certainly not at the cost of doing away with our national assets, that is by selling or privatizing profit-making public sector companies. It is shocking that the monetization project included sale of valuable land held by the public sector companies. The increase in FDI in insurance from 49% to 74% is highly objectionable. It is as good as handing over the profit-making insurance sector to foreign players and corporates. This step has resulted into widespread anger and resentment among the insurance employees. I would urge upon the government to review this decision in the interest of the insurance industry and the people of India. Sir, disinvestment and strategic sale of BPCL, Air India, Shipping Corporation of India, Container Corporation of BEML, Pawan Hans need to be reviewed by the government. Similarly, the proposal to privatize two public sector banks and one general insurance company should be scrapped, as these are profit-making national assets who also create job opportunities to the unemployed youth. LIC is the richest corporation which has huge profit base and serves the interests of crores of Indian policyholders. It has been playing key role in the financial market and also pays handsome annual dividend to the Government of India. The proposal to bring IPO in LIC would be an unwelcome step, as it would lose its glory to the utter disappointment of lakhs of Indians. Sir, under inclusive development for aspirational India, agriculture credit has been enhanced to 16.5 lakh crores, but this huge outlay is far from satisfying the expectations of farmers. All that farmer needs is inclusion of MSP in the farm laws and not oral assurance. Farmers have been demanding MSP based on Swaminathan Commission's formula of C2 plus 50%, but ensuring 1.5 times the cost of production on crops will not help in addressing the farmer's plight, as it does not provide remunerative price. Farmer demand that the farm laws enacted by the government be withdrawn and they are given opportunity for hearing. I hope Prime Minister would give them the opportunity and resolve their contentious crisis, as more than 75 days have gone, the farmer community is agitating at the borders of Delhi. Sir, rupees 300 crore has been provided to the government of Goa for the Diamond Jubilee celebrations of the state's liberation from Portuguese. So my state of Maharashtra has also just celebrated its Diamond Jubilee in 2020. So why Maharashtra was dropped? So during COVID pandemic, Honorable Prime Minister had declared 20,000 crore package to overcome the depressive situation in the country and revive the economy by creating jobs and giving thrust to MSMEs. But nothing seemed to have worked on the ground. There is no mention about this in the budget. What evolved out of this package? Sir, still demand is sluggish. Though banks and financial institutions are flushed with money, there is no credit offtake. Unemployment is rampant due to non-availability of jobs. Under the situation, the government should put money in the hands of the people to create demand and thus revive the economy. The falling rupee and ever-rising fuel prices have broken the backbone of the common man. Government needs to take immediate corrective steps in this direction. Sir, in the entire budget, hardly anything substantial has been budgeted for my state of Maharashtra. It's with great regret I would state that Mumbai, the financial capital of India, contributes maximum to the exchequer by way of taxes, and in return, hardly Mumbai gets anything. Moreover, the rightful dues
Mr. Desai.
I'm just concluding one minute. Only concluding. Moreover, the rightful dues of GST amounting to around 25,000 crores have also remained in arrears. It was expected that Maharashtra will be provided substantially, but nothing has come our way. But the states which are going for elections have been provided liberally with an eye on elections. Sir, spirit of cooperative federalism should be reflected in the budget in a better way in time to come. Thank you. Thank you.
Next speaker is...